Greetings and hello everybody, welcome back to Anno, and this time we're looking at, well, Sleepy Hollow, because here we do have something that finally I'm doing after so much time, and that is building a hospital. Sleepy Hollow, as we know, is collapsing quite often from, well, plagues. And now we do have the resources then to finally build something here that we can do. After all, Sleepy Hollow was our first town in this game, and it also was, well, our first major town that we had, and kind of like our jump point, so we should actually care for it a bit more, I think. And a good hospital is the first step towards it. I was also thinking about the sanatorium, but look at the size of this thing, and yep, up here is a good destination for it. The problem though is that the doctors would just need a lot of time to get into the city itself, so I'd rather just have the hospital here in the center, piling up just beside the, or being built just beside the police station. And this is only one, we are going to have two. There we have the next ruins already. I can use this moment there to finally also get rid of some of these buildings there for good, and instead of that have another hospital here. So finally we have solved it. Look at that, the next plague is already coming up again. Pretty incredible when you think about how dirty Sleepy Hollow must be when there are so many plagues. Now, I do have two sailing shipyards here. I'm going to get rid of one of them. The reason for that is I was promising that I would at least try to get the AI shipyard into the game. And there we have it in all its glory. AI shipyard has been built. That's even a newspaper article that we get out of this. And what do we have here now? Well, we do have the option of actually getting more opponents into this game, right? And some of them are more interesting than others. For example, the Baron from Malking with the military mod is actually a 4-star AI opponent. He's pretty strong, and I would like to get him into this game. Yes, let's build him. We do have the resources for him. We could actually also resurrect Miss Hunt again, but I'm not doing that, of course. Baron von Malking, he's taking his time now, 30 minutes it would take him, and just before he gets finished, we would, well, probably get rid of this island here, and, you know, open it up again for some new settling, and this would be possible. But yeah, it's just a matter of waiting now. But at least Sleepy Hollow has been, you know, fixed in this regard, even though it was just a small colony, of course, you know, it's all about Crown Falls anyway. In Crown Falls, we have finished the next research that we can have here now. So the Great Eastern Pyramid, this allows us now to build a Great Eastern, I think, one, right? So it's usually not that much. Now, something else that we can do here that I would like to go is change fertility. I haven't done this yet as well. I think the researching just takes way too much time though, right? So it's a lot of time. Even if we have 20,000 engineers on it, it still takes 50 minutes now to complete the research. So this is kind of like a hard lock that you are in. So a limit, time limit. So, you know, you can't just endlessly research because the limit just gets so high. And 50 minutes is a long time. Now, in Crown Falls, we do have, though, something to do. We have our export and import contracts, as we can see. And we have two goods here that are pretty high now, level 2. I've actually stopped using them because champagne is running out, as we can see. We're producing a lot of champagne. The problem is Tobias is coming in so often that the champagne gets really depleted if we use it on too many things at once. That means that also with the soap, since those are my two primary goods right now, we should up the production for those thingies. So, first of all, oh, there's also the Darkness 3 coming in, the airship with, hopefully, yeah, enough gas. Very good. So we have a lot of gas now coming in here. And what we can do now for the docks, let's just see. Do we have, let's see, we have tallow, quite a lot of it. Do we have piggies? We have a lot of piggies. We are also importing the piggies into Crown Falls, that we're going to need them. And bread is also capped, despite the fact, oh, wait a second. Sausage is going down now slowly. We might actually put them back up there again. I don't need to import any more, you know, piggies and stuff like that. What I would like to do though is I would like to up my soap and my champagne production. So first of all, we can have additional soap factories here. In fact, let's have three more that I'm going to need. And as we can see here, well, we do have a power station. Let's activate the power station. It is an oil power station at the moment. And as far as I remember, yes, we do have quite a lot of oil now. Look at that. There's even more oil coming in. So oil-wise, we should be in a very good spot now. 1,000 oil that we have in the storage right now, thanks to all the new oil productions. And look at that. The tracks are quite busy, as far as I can see. I think those trains are way too close to each other. But yeah, looking good, right? Lots of oil being transported around the city, polluting my city as well, and also transporting, of course, the passengers from one station to another. This is just fantastic overall, how much traffic on the tracks we have now. Oh, this one's actually going somewhere else. And yep, we do have now another power station that is producing then some soap for us. Very important. I do need more soap since we use that quite heavily. Another thing is my champagne production up here. We do have our wine or vineyards that we have up there, my wine fields and the grape fields, that is. And let's just check how much do we have of that. We have a lot of grapes, right? The problem is that they also need glass, and glass is something that's not so easy to produce, especially since we do need it a lot. We have our sand mines down here. We can use now the new layout that we had, you know, planned out for these sand mines here that we have. Let's just have a look at that. There is the sand mine. How far can it look into this direction? Oh, not very far from what I can see, right? So we could have it blueprinted like this and squeeze in three of them and three of them here, for example. And then it would, of course, also need a street. So this is how far we could go. I don't think we saved a lot of space with that, right? So this is not. Problem is the harbor area mod is not working anymore, so I can't enlarge in my harbor space too much. Oh, come on. This is not a lot, though. Nah, unfortunately. We could try it like this. Ah, very good. This is actually working, okay. Then it's worth it. And probably like this. Okay, this is actually workable. The only problem I see here is, yep, we do still need, however, a road going all the way to the warehouse, of course. And then we can add them to this area. At least three more. Yeah, that's quite a few, actually. And they're also, of course, always going to those large warehouses there. We're going to increase them because we do now have a couple of more of them. And another cool thing is that we have actually, yep, a bit of space here now between the tourism port and my sand mines, even though, of course, it's not looking so good. But we do need it since we are a champagne producer, or a major champagne producer. And we do definitely want to have a huge production of that working for us. Very good. Can we use any ornaments here in between so that this looks a bit more like a harbor? And oh yeah, what is happening in the meantime? Hugo actually settled on the second plateau up here. So he's got this plateau now under his control, which is the worst of them because it's very long and slim. And this one here he's taken for himself now too, which is a very nice one because it's got this nice glacier lake there in the center, just looking fantastic overall. But what is he doing with that? Is he actually pumping out the gas? I think he is. Yes, look at that. He's also using the gas for his cities there. And he's also got the airships working on that. Pretty cool. I'm really glad that the AI is using this one too. And yes, at least out here we can have a little, you know, kiosk where people can go and enjoy the view just out here, very far away from everything. And this should bring us in a lot of glass. Now let's just get back to my industrial zone. We do have a glass production already somewhere, and I would like to get a more glass production here. That we do have our glass makers, and we do still have the space for it. Let's push them. We have 12 sand mines and the glass makers I can use just here. They're also being then powered by the power station that we have there. Let's just have a few of them here. Very good, right next to the warehouse that we have there. And we still have a bit of more space for some other factories if we need to, right? For example, our champagne production. Oh well, do we really want to have them in the industrial zone? I don't think so. We can definitely have at least two more of them now. And productivity, let's reduce the productivity again because we don't need that. We have the space and we are boosting it by electricity, so we can just build all four of them. How much glass do we have anyway? We should be having a lot of glass. 3,000. tons of that, so I will definitely get a few more champagne cellars up now. So important to have them. There we already have three. I still have the space for one more, and brass I don't need that much, so let's get rid of those two here, and instead of that use at least one we can use as well in this area for some additional champagne production. They're boosted, right? They have electricity, very good. And yeah, we could also boost it by another 50%. The artisan happiness is fine for that. I still have my artisanal kitchen here, so that is something we should not need anymore, plus the cannery as well. Very good. So actually we are even with when it comes to the happiness of my people. Look at that, they're all pretty happy at the moment. Very good. Now that's a lot of champagne. Hopefully we produce enough. I could also always, you know, get a few more vineyards up there if I want to. Now something else is happening is that we can get our next rewards here. The highest ones once again for the archaeology. Let's have a look at them. Oh, very good. Two legendaries item. Augustan Forum and the Goidelic Stone Circle. I don't think that I have this one yet. Very good. We might just use one of them on the last free spot that we have there for the exhibitions. And the Goidelic Stone Circle. Yes, I don't have that yet. And it's just looking fantastic in here. Perfect. Very nice museum that we have there. What we also need to check is, of course, our rum production that we started at some point. We should be having, oh yes, a lot of rum. Unfortunately, the storage is also getting rather full. We have the resources here, though, to get another storage up there or another depot here. Oh, and Princess Qing and Anne Harlow are at war with each other. I don't mind this at all. And perhaps, yep, we could also have some more storage depots then here piling up just beside that as another pier that we are using. And also the oil is coming in. Ooh, are we really that full on oil here as well? We do have the oil trade route, right? What is that anyway? It's Quilmy. And there we have it. And we should be, yep, we have one. But it seems like it's not enough. Do we need another oil tanker perhaps? Or do we have one available? No, we don't. Nope. So let's get us another oil tanker. And another thing, of course, is the rum. So we also have a rum trade route available here with two ships. Both of them are on the way right now. So I can add another one now to the trade route here. Flying Dodo, which is already waiting right in front of it, can start the trade route now. And should be getting a lot of rum on its way to Crown Falls. Very good, another 400 tons. We do have now two major trade routes, or two major islands producing rum for our island, and rum is so much needed because artisans and engineers alike do need it, and that's quite a lot of people that we have. As we can see, it's working, and isn't that just looking fantastic? I love the lighting in this game, the lighting so that we have there with the fields especially, beautiful. And in Crown Falls, we can also check how much we produce of each good now. And look at that, the sausages and the soap is at 47 and the champagne is at 15. That could even be higher, I think. Very good. So we have a huge surplus of these goods that we need for our importing and exporting, right? There was also another trader once again. As we can see, only 2,000 champagne needs to be exported now. And around 3,000 to get to level 1, the exporter level legendary. And yeah. Basically, that's it though. There's not much reason behind, or I don't see any big advantage now at this point in the late game, since, you know, we do have every resource actually available to us. So I think this makes a lot of sense when you are on the single map with hard AI opponents, so you can't have all the maps available to you. But we have all the maps available to us, right? So the Harbor DLC doesn't make so much sense when you have Crown Falls and when you have a lot of islands under your control. It makes a lot of sense though when you have, for example, not Crown Falls, and you only play on the old world, and, you know, some islands have been taken that have the valuable resources. Then I think the harbor makes a lot of sense, because then you can specialize into goods that you have, but we have all the goods that we need, right? So there's not much reason for the harbor. Now, this one here, Todd Murden, I still want to keep for now, and let's just see another 13 minutes for Baron von Melking to come to life, and then we would have a new opponent in this game. We can also fill in a few more slots here for the zoo. So we still have the bearded vulture, an epic item that we got from Africa. So we can use it in this area there. I think, yeah, it's a bird, right? Should be a bird. And there we have it. I don't see it. There it is. Actually, yes. Very good. Two of them. There is not even a cage or something like that. And people just sit around as if it is... Okay. I guess. Very good. There we got this one. And what else do we have? A dromedary. Let's have this one on the outer edges. There we have them. And another pygmy hedgehog. So all of them were from the Africa, actually. Let's use this one here with the buildings. Right, so we have the buildings closer together. Very good. I think this one here, what are you? A snail. Okay, let's use the snail down here as well with the buildings. So we have the buildings on that side. And then, you know, the animals that you can see actually in the outer area. Everywhere else. A beautiful zoo that is growing. And look at that, the people of Sleepy Hollow, they celebrate the new arrival of the hospital, obviously. I should also probably give them some paved roads here, so they can celebrate in a decent fashion, right, where all these people parade at the moment. Very good, so there we have that. Hopefully no more big outbreaks. And oh, we got a lot of processions here in this beautiful town. And what we should also be doing is, I'm going to get rid of Todmorden now. There we have it. And also of this island here, Calthrive. Both of them I don't need anymore. Why is that the case? Because, well, there he is. Also, the Baron from Melking is coming out. Fly, little bird, fly. And hopefully you are providing us with another additional... Yeah, challenges that come ahead. He's focusing on economic warfare usually. So he's building up something... a strong economy, and also then of course waging war against us. So he's trying to find an island now, and yeah, Sleepy Hollow is looking good now as well. I think this is a nice conclusion to where we started with this whole playthrough. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to stop for now with this game. We are going to see some new opponents, some new DLCs, and then we continue with this playthrough. Other than that, new challenges await us, of course. Stay tuned.